Hey, this is Nathan Holmquist of booktothefuture.com and ScanLister.com, and for this video I'm going to show you how to provide box content information part 2. So ScanLister now has two ways to add box content information. The first way is to print 2D barcode labels and put it on each box. And if you missed that video, I'll try to put it right here so you can watch it. The second way is to upload a packlist file. So I made an easy way to do that, and there are some advantages of uploading a packlist file versus printing 2D barcodes. The first one is there's no 50 unit limit on each box. So when you're printing 2D barcodes, there's only so many ASINS that can fit in that barcode, and we found the max is about 50 units, which isn't a problem when you're doing books for boxes, but if you have a lot of CDs or DVDs to put in a box, lots of times you're going to have over 50 units per box. So that's when a packlist file would be much better. The second advantage is there's no need to print labels. You don't have to worry about getting a label damage during shipment. And the final advantage is that you can verify if the upload was successful before you send your shipment off to Amazon. So you know that you and Amazon are in agreement to what's in each box, and you'll know that your box content is successful and you're ready to go. So for the second part of the video, I'm going to show you an example of how to use the packlist file on ScanLister. And see you on the other side. Thanks. Alright, so here's the second part of the video, and as you can see, I have a shipment of 93 books that I'm working on right here. I've already listed them. I've already put the FBA stickers on the back of each book. They're right here. Most of them I already have in boxes right here, but I want to get the box content information. I want to start doing that. So I'm going to copy the shipment ID, go to ScanLister, go to box content, and that will bring up this screen right here. So what you would do is go to new shipment and paste in the shipment ID right here. Now it's not going to look full like this because I already started working on it. It's going to look blank like this when you first start out. You can scroll through the boxes, but box one, which is right here, I have 28 books in it, and I'm going to put a few more books in box one. As you can see, I have about 6 more books that I need to put in the boxes to finish up the shipment. So here's the FN SKU number or the FBA sticker on the back right here. So what I'm going to do is scan that before I put it in the box. I'm going to put a couple in box one there. Then I'm going to go to box two by clicking the arrow. And as you can see, there's already 34 books in there right here that I've been working on. I'm going to add a couple more books to there. In box three, I have 24 books down here in box three. So I'm just going to finish up the shipment here. Oops. Box three, finish up the shipment. And I have everything scanned in 3 boxes. And you can delete items and put it in another box. So I'm on box three right here. So let's say I wanted to put this one in box one instead. Just go ahead and select that and press the delete button on your keyboard, and you can delete that and scan it in box one. So once you put it in a box, it's not there forever. You can move it around if you want. Just make sure you delete it first. Okay, now I'm ready to get the packing slip. So these first two are for printing the 2D barcodes, which is in the first video. But I want to get the packing slip, the Excel box content. So I'm going to select that for the template and click export. And I'm going to name the file box content 1018. Save that. Now I'll go ahead and open it. And here here's a packing slip, and it's in the exact format that Amazon wants. It has the shipment ID, the SKU, ASIN, title, FN SKU number, and it has three columns. Since I have three boxes, it has three columns here. And it's got all the books. For example, this one right here, it's just showing that it's under the box two column, so it's in box two. So it's all filled out, it is ready to go. The only thing you need to do is put in the weight right here. I've noticed that instead of doing it on the Seller Central account, you actually do it right here. So I'm just gonna keep it simple and just put 50 pounds for each box right here. So that is all set. So there's your packing slip, and I'm gonna go ahead and save that one more time. Now let's go ahead and go back to our shipment. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and select more than one SKU per box. I'm gonna go to upload file. Fill out a pack list and upload a file to Seller Central. And right here, I'm gonna go ahead and put in three boxes. And it says generate a pack list template. Even though I'm not gonna use this template, I still wanna generate it. That way it'll allow me to upload the file that I got from ScanLister. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose the file, the same one that I saved on ScanLister, box content 1018. Upload that. And as you can see, it says in progress, so I'm going to click and refresh that. And it says done. So 94 were requested and 94 were successful. So I'm all set to go. And as you can see, I don't need to enter the box weight right here. It already says three boxes, 150 pounds. So that's it for this video. I just wanted to show you how you can use the box content feature on ScanLister on how to upload a pack list file instead of the 2D barcode.